Good morning and welcome to day 4 of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 10. Very, very different weather today. What a shame. It started out so nicely as well. Anyway, not to worry. Good morning. How are we doing? You okay? It's a bit of a shame that the weather's changed. It's very dull, very grey. It's been raining quite a wee bit during the night, you know, but it's still not actually that cold. It's still quite mild. So, and as the wind's died down a wee bit, so it's not actually got a chill to the air at all at the moment. So it looks like, despite the weather, it might still be an okay day. Maybe, you know. The time is currently, it's about 8:15, I think it is. And I've been up for about an hour or so already, so this is not my first cup of coffee. And I'm definitely feeling a lot more alive this morning than I was yesterday. I was definitely, by the time I came back to the boat after my little excursion at the ferry house, which is just over there, I was dead to the world, you know. It had actually been a couple of really long days, you know, early morning, early starts, late nights, meeting up with so many good people, but drinking just that little bit way too much, you know. I was, it was, I think by the time I'd finished my dinner last night, I'd had a few beers in the pub. I was trying to think, what did I have? Oh, I had the Southwold Bitter. That's what I had. Had a few of them, and I sort of came back to the boat, and basically I crashed. I absolutely crashed, dead to the world, you know. And it was like, let me just put this down. There we go. I totally crashed, dead to the world. I think I was in bed before 8:00 last night, I think, possibly, you know. I pretty much slept all the way through, you know. So, definitely feeling a bit more rested and relaxed. Ready for the day. That's obviously the summer light. They came in round about, I think it was about 5:00. I was sitting there watching. As I'd hoped, I'd left enough space for them. That wind had kept the bow swinging, but they managed to get in no problems, so that was the main thing. I helped them in as well, you know, so they were in there no problems. So everything went okay, and it was actually quite a nice wee mooring, actually. Despite the fact that there was a wee bit of a wind blowing down the river, and it kept sort of swinging the bow of the boat a wee bit, and there was a wee bit of bow slap in the bow of the boat, but obviously I'm sleeping at the back, so that didn't bother me. And once some of the other boats here, they came in, that meant that I obviously had a nice wee sort of a shelter from the wind. So yeah, everything went actually okay last night, so I was quite happy about that, you know. Nice wee mooring, you know. Sirlingham Ferry House, oh, excellent place, absolutely excellent place. It was such a great place, you know, just to go and have a drink. As you know, it's one of these places where you don't need to go and have a food or dinner, you know, like you go to things like the Ferry Inn at Stokesby or the Bridge Inn at Acle, you know. These places you go in to eat, you know. So you can just go come here and just have drinks, you know, a bit of a bar or sit outside, you know. It was glorious outside in the sun, it really was. But the Ferry House at Sirlingham, oh, you know, the food. Really, really nice. And I didn't actually have too much. I didn't have anything fancy. They had this chicken leek and Stilton pie, which was so tempting. But I just ended up having some brie wedges and some cod and chips, and That was a big bit of cod. A big bit of cod with a huge dish of garden peas on it. So yeah, it was really good. It was a bit sort of basic, you know, and simple for a dinner, you know, nothing gourmet-ish or fancy or anything like that. But after the weekend of meeting everybody and drinking copious excesses of alcohol and very good food, you know, it felt good to just sort of have something a wee bit sort of simpler and plain, so to speak, you know. So yeah, really glad I stopped here. But what is on the agenda for today? Well, that is a thing, isn't it? I'm still, if I'm honest, I am still a wee bit torn. Just a wee couple of... Yeah. If I'm honest, I'm still a wee bit torn as to what exactly I want to do today. The weather today is not the best. Tomorrow is supposed to be a bit worse tomorrow. It's supposed to be a lot wetter. So yeah, it's not going to be ideal weather the next couple of days. So one plan I could do, I could go down to Loddon on the River Shet. Been a wee while since I've been there. I could go down there, or I could go all the way down to Beccles. Been a wee while since I want to go, since I've been to Beccles. I did actually want to do a wee bit of the River Waveney on this trip. Or if it's going to be sort of dull and miserable and not very good, I could go back north today, you know. And what I'm currently thinking is that since I'm up at Sirlingham, you know, low tide is about, slack water is about 20 past, quarter past one. So if I left about, I don't know, nine, half nine, I could actually take a nice wee cruise down to Great Yarmouth, across Breydon into Great Yarmouth. And then I've got a choice. I can either stay at Great Yarmouth, which I must admit, you know, it is quite tempting, you know, not so much for actually visiting the yacht station, but for going in and spending a load of money in the amusements, which I never got a chance to do in July, you know. So yeah, there is that possibility. Have a very sort of lazy sort of day and, you know, just sort of chill and relax, you know. Or I could maybe just keep on going up to Stokes Bay, you know, and stop and pop into the ferry house at Stokes Bay. Yeah, so I'm not entirely sure. I've got some choices. The problem is that if I stay on the Southern Broads today, slack water tomorrow is half two, which means that I could go all the way down to Beccles today, and I would still be able to leave at a, you know, sort of mid-morning, you know, leave Beccles mid-morning tomorrow, and I would still get my crossing at slack water on Breydon tomorrow. But the problem then is that, well, if I make all that journey up, you know, then I would have to go back into the Northern Broads, you know, and it's just like, because tomorrow is Wednesday, it's getting near the end of the holiday, and I don't think I want to stop at Great Yarmouth tomorrow and then continue into the Northern Broads on Thursday. I don't think I really want to do that. So, but that would be a long cruise from Beccles to Great Yarmouth and then up to, say, Acle or something like that. You know, that would be 6-7 hours, something like that, give or take. So that's a long cruise day. That would be a very long cruise day. And if the weather's really miserable tomorrow, Breydon might be a bit rough and windy, and so I'm not really sure if that would actually be a good idea. So maybe if the weather's going to be rubbish over the next 2 days, go back north but split the journey up into two sections, you know. 4 hours or so into Great Yarmouth from here, and then another 2-3 hours back into somewhere into the Northern Broads tomorrow. That sounds like a plan, actually. I'm quite liking that plan, you know. But we'll wait and see, you know. Like I say, you know what I'm like, you know. Everything changes, you know. I mean, I come up with all these ideas, certainly, you know, and then, you know, half an hour down the river, totally change my idea, go for something different, and then I get to Reedham or something like that, and but instead of turning left, I'll maybe go down the Newcart, and who knows? So we'll wait and see, we'll wait and see. But yeah, that's the update. It's a nice morning. Well, it's not a nice morning, it's a dull, horrible, grey, yuck morning, but it's dry for the moment, you know, and more importantly, it's not cold, so we'll wait and see how the day goes. But I'm gonna go get my coffee, get myself organized. I'll probably leave in the next half hour or so, take a wee slow meander down and see where the day takes us. But as always, I'll keep you updated on the events of the day. So until later, I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now. Cheers.
Hey, just a little wee update for you. I am on my way, and as you can probably see, the roof is up. It started out dull and grey, and it had been wet, but the rain is now on, and it's coming down pretty heavily. Typical. But no, I am on my way. I think I've possibly left just a little bit too early. Maybe by about half an hour or so, but I was sitting there and I was just sort of watching the time and just like, you know, actually, the hell with it. I'm just gonna go. I'm not gonna play it actually by the minute. I'm gonna arrive possibly a wee bit too early, but it doesn't really matter. It doesn't really matter at all, you know. In the grand scheme of things, it's not going to be that early. And as long as I don't catch the full outgoing flow from the River Bure, I'll be fine. And yes, I did say the full outgoing river flow of the River Bure, because I'm heading north today. I've decided I'm heading north today. The weather is just, it's really not nice, So I may as well do a long cruise through that sort of no man's land, if you like, on the miserable day, you know. So I'm going to head north, and then I'll spend a few days up north before the end of the adventure. So I'm still not sure though if I'm going to break it up, you know. I quite like the idea of breaking it up, but Great Yarmouth is not the easiest place to moor up when you're by yourself, so I was just actually having a think of that, especially if the canopy is up, you know, and the tide's going out. I cannot easily get out my starboard side to moor up, and if it's low water, the rangers can't easily grab my ropes for me, so yeah, this might not be actually doable to stop at Great Yarmouth when I'm by myself. Don't know. We shall wait and see. We shall figure something out. But it doesn't matter, you know. It doesn't matter, you know. I'm going to head north today, though. I'm going to split the journey up into two parts. So it'll be either I'll stop at Great Yarmouth or keep on going and maybe stop at Stokes Bay. But I'll not do much more than that, then I'll just be fluttering around up in the top of the Northern Broads for the rest of the adventure, you know. I do enjoy coming down here, and like I say, I had actually hoped to nip down into the River Waveney for a wee while. Kind of hope to go to Beckles as well, you know, I must admit. Oh well, never mind, you know. No, don't worry, you know. It's just the way things all sort of pan out and work out, isn't it? Apart from the weather, it's looking to be, it's going to be a good day on the river, but it's going to be a wet and miserable and dull day. So, that's the update. I really know how to turn one word or one sentence into a multitude, don't I, sometimes? Right. So, long story short, I'm on my way. I've left my moorings. I'm heading north. I still don't know if I'm doing exactly where my overnight mooring will be, but it will be somewhere in the Northern Broads. So, as always, I'll keep you updated. So until then, bye for now. Cheers! just a little wee update for you. I'm currently just leaving Brundle, actually, I'm just going past the, that really, really difficult name. It shouldn't be difficult, it's not difficult to pronounce, it's just a difficult name. What is it, the Coldham Hall House Pub? It's a really, really weird name. It just, you know how most pubs, you know, they make it easier, it rolls off the tongue, you know, like the Swan, the Ferry House, the Ferry Inn, you know, the Red Lion, you know, the Reed Cutter, you know, Fur and Feathers, you know, it's just something that just sort of rolls off the tongue. It's easy to remember. It's just, you know, that place is, it's no easy at all, you know, Coldham Hall Pub. I'm quite sure if you said it a lot of times, you know, it would just be second nature, but I always have problems trying to figure out exactly what that place is called. Anyway, I'm just passing there, and leaving Brundle and heading down the river. I did have a wee think, because obviously where I was at Sirlingham, you know, the river does a wee sort of horseshoe shape like that into Brundle, you know, and Sirlingham Broad is like in the middle, and I could have nipped through it, and I was going to do that, actually, you know, but to tell you the truth, it's just dull and grey and miserable and wet, and it's no nice, you know. So I kind of figured if I want to go in there, you know, I want to go in there when it's at least not dull and grey and miserable and wet, you know, because it just doesn't look good on the camera, you know, and because there's nothing there, you know, it's just a small tiny wee broad tucked away in the corner, you know, I just thought, so I just went round the horseshoe, and besides, I wanted to go back round the horseshoe because obviously there's a lot of big boat yards down there. But I noticed when I was coming up the river yesterday is that there's a couple of sort of Dutch barges and wide beams canal boats, obviously privately owned, you know, all sitting there on the rivers as moorings, and I just wanted another wee look at them. So I went round the horseshoe and didn't go through Sirlingham Broad, you know. So, and I really need to pay a visit to Sirlingham Broad again sometime soon, you know. But other than that, we're just cruising on down the river, everything's going okay. It's not cold, but it's not exactly very, very warm, you know. And it's just the weather. It's just the way it is, you know. But everything's going good. And I must say, the boat's actually quite comfortable. I am liking it. Although I do have a minor problem, you know. And it's just a little problem, okay. And I know most of you, will be going, oh, what a wuss. What a wuss, get a grip, man, you know? Man up! And you're probably right. I should just sort of man up and just sort of deal with it, okay? But I was messing around last night, okay? And I've got a pet, right? And he's living in the bow, okay? Now, it's a spider. It's a spider. I won't lie. It's a spider, you know? But I mean, it's like, we're not talking like a nice, friendly, your neighborhood friendly spider man type spider, you know? Oh, no. We're talking shelob here, you know? And I mean shelob, okay? Is it shelob? You know? If you know who I'm talking about, you'll know. Yeah. Return of the King, aye. Lord of the Rings, aye. Yeah. Shelob, yeah. That's who we're talking about, by the way, okay? She's living in that front bloody cabin, by the way, okay? And she's like, well, she's not actually living in the front cabin. That would be okay. I could just shut the door, lock it, and just never, ever enter into that. That would be fine, but she's not actually living on the cabin. She's made her home, okay, on the door, in the passageway to the front cabin, okay? Right? And she, bloody massive, man, you know? I freaked out when I saw her yesterday, you know? I'm like, oh my God, you know? So yeah, I ain't going down there, by the way. That's off limits now, you know? I'm gonna burn that, absolutely. This boat will sink before I go down that bloody passageway again. Absolutely, I'm just not going there at all, you know? No. I know, it's only a shelob. It's only a spider, you know? But it's this big, massive spider, you know? Huge, you know? It's looking at me with hungry eyes, you know? Honestly, I damn near torpedoed this thing last night, you know? That's it, okay, I'm finished, done and dusted, you know? Just leave it, I'm gone. All joking aside, she is still living there. I haven't touched her, you know? I'm sort of gathering strength and courage, you know? And my armies, you know? I'm needing a lot of armies before I go down there and take care of her, you know? I've yet decided if I'm going to be nice and humane and catch her and release her out into the wild, or if I'm just going to go in there all guns blazing and literally just like incinerate her. I haven't quite decided that yet, you know. Squash her to hell, you know. But yeah, I can't squash her. Do you have any idea the mess she would make? Oh, no. Oh, anyway. So yeah, I've got a wee problem in the bow of the boat, you know, that I'm trying to live with at the moment. Oh, wonderful. So yeah, anyway, other than that, the boat's actually very nice. It's actually quite comfortable. The bed's really nice. I like the bed, you know. It's a bit of a small double, you know, but it's quite nice, you know. Although, I think being a small double, if anybody was to like join me, you know, not that anybody does join me, you know, but if somebody was in that bed with me, you know, at the moment, you know, I'm enjoying the bed too much, you know, I'm like, you know, all over the place, you know, they'd be like crammed up against under the freeboard, and I'd be like, myself, bugger off, I'm like, no, this is King's lovely, I'm loving this, you know. Oh dear. I don't know. I think I'm in a bit of a strange mood today. You know. which is a bit odd. I shouldn't be in a strange mood because it's really dull and miserable. I should be in a foul mood, but for some reason I'm not. I think it's because last night, you know, I got such a good, I mean literally, you know. I came back from the ferry house, you know, got on, settled down, had a couple of becks, watched a wee bit of Star Trek, Deep Space Nine. I'm a science fiction geek, you know, so, you know, that's just me. and literally, by about 7:30, I was dead to the world. I could not keep my eyes open, you know. And I was just like, oh, you know, that's it. I'm crashing. I'm checking out, you know, so. But I think that was because I had such late nights, over the weekend, you know. Obviously I met so many people on Saturday, and then I met a few people on the Sunday, you know. There were late nights, there were heavy drinking nights, you know. I'd been up early in the morning, and yeah, I'd just been, oh, I just totally crashed last night. So yeah, got a good sleep, you know. But yeah, everything's going okay, you know, despite the horrible weather. But I'm just taking it easy. I'm just literally dawdling down the river, you know, about five and a half miles an hour in a six zone, you know. I'm not taking my time. I'm not rushing. I'm just taking my time, you know. No rush at all. So yeah, everything's good. Anyway, that's the update so far. I'll keep you updated on the events of the day. So until later, I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now. Cheers. We'll be right back. Okay, just a little wee update for you. Okay, right, this is an update, okay, but I'm kind of thinking now, and yes, things might need to change actually. You see, one of the good things about the whole Brundle area, you know, is that as a general rule, you know, you don't get much of a signal there at all, you know. It's a wee bit like Horning, you know. For most people, it's a bit of like a phone internet black spot, you know. You occasionally get a very minor signal pop up, but as a general rule, you've no internet, okay? And sometimes you've no phone signal at all. You know, this is good because I mean it's totally out of touch, you know. I mean the only internet signal I had last night was when I went in for my meal at the ferry house and hooked up to their Wi-Fi. Only way I could get a signal. Well, I've left Brundle now and I'm going down the river and I'm just keeping an eye on the phone, and basically it started ping, bing, 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 ding, you know, all the various emails and messages and what have you, you know, started coming through, and I went, oh, okay, I've got a signal again. So I thought, well, it's turning into a wee bit of a rubbish day, you know, let's just see how rubbish it is and check the weather. Yeah, maybe I didn't want to do that, actually. Because I said earlier, you know, today and tomorrow is going to be a bit bleh, and tomorrow's like, yeah, just going to be horrible. Well, it looks like, for the most part, excuse me, today and tomorrow have conspired with each other and just decided, to hell with splitting it all up, let's dump the whole lot today. So, yeah, okay. I wish I'd kind of realised that before I left. I might have altered my plans. But basically, we've got heavy rain all day, and we're going to have thunder later. And it's going to be windy, and it's going to be cold, and you can see I've put something on, you know, because it is getting a bit chill. I'm even thinking short corner of putting the heating on, you know, because the boat is getting a wee bit chilly. And yeah, the wind's picking up, because the current's going out at the moment, the wind's coming towards me, so we've got a bit of wave action going on here. Footage on the GoPro at the moment is just pathetic, you know, it's just horrible, and it's probably going to be unusable because the rain's being driven onto the lens at the moment and all you're seeing is just a mass of raindrops. So this may very, very well be a talking vlog, by the way. I'll have the footage, it'll just be rubbish footage and I might not use it, so I apologise if this turns into a talking vlog. But yeah, so basically it's going to be a really, really rubbish day. But, and tomorrow's supposed to be a little bit better, you know, it's supposed to be a little bit brighter, it's going to be less rain, it's going to be more showery stuff, you know. Today's just like sort of full on, and I'm kind of thinking, well, maybe I should just sort of give up on the plans of going north today, and just have like a long cruise day tomorrow instead. Maybe just have a short cruise day today, maybe down to Loddon, Rivershed, or Reedham, or something like that. Leave late tomorrow and just straight up, you know. But like I say, I mean, my problem with that is low slack water isn't till like 2:30, you know. Low water is 1:30, but even if I go across at say 2:00, you know, I get there and then it's like another 2 hours to Acle, and then I'm actually supposed to be meeting, I wasn't gonna say, but kind of arranged to meet up with Malcolm on Moonlight Shadow. He's currently north. I passed him obviously on Sunday. We got talking, and he's currently north. He's planning on heading south, back south on Thursday, because this is where he's based in the Southern Broads. So he's planning on coming back south on the Thursday. So he was going to spend the night on Thorndyke at the Lion. And I thought, oh, really? Thorndyke and the Lion? And I know, I've already been to the Lion, I know, you know. But it was just like, well, actually, you know, I could come up on Wednesday, you know, and go into the Lion, you know, because let's face it, I mean, it's the Lion, you know. You know, have a few beers, you know, and catch up and have a wee look at Moonlight Shadow, you know. But if I don't get across until 2:30, even 2:00, you know, it's going to be like 5:00 by the time I get up to Thorndyke, you know, and it's, you know, it might be a bit too busy then. And this is one reason why I wanted to do it in two parts, you know, get up into like the Great Yarmouth area, spend the night, relax, a nice short cruise in the horrible weather, and then tomorrow I can just go up the river, float around a wee bit, but still get into Thorndyke around about lunchtime and just sort of relax and chill, and then go out for a lovely evening into the Lion again, you know. That's one thing that I thought about doing. But like I say, you know, I mean, if I try and cross tomorrow on Wednesday instead, you know, there's no guarantee I'm going to get in at Thorndyke, because it's going to be like damn near 5 o'clock. So it's one of those difficult situations I need to sort of mull over in my head a wee bit, you know, because I'm going to need to figure out, because if the weather really is, I mean, it's getting quite atrocious now, you know. I've only been able to go for about, well, not that long, but long enough, you know, to see the weather slowly deteriorating, you know. The rain's coming on, it's being more persistent, it's getting heavier, the wind's picking up, you know. I mean, it's not going to be like gale force wind or anything like that, but it's a stiff breeze, you know. I think Breydon could be a bit of a choppy crossing, actually, you know. We could be in for a wee bit of a interesting time if I decide to cross it, but it will be crossable, you know. That's no problem. But yeah, it's just a totally horrible day, and it's just like, well, do I really want to make the crossing today? If the weather is going to be truly that bad, you know, will I even want to go into Great Yarmouth and leave the boat? You know, I'll probably end up just getting soaked. So yeah, it's one of these difficult situations, you know. I'm going to try and figure out exactly what it is that I want to do. I mean, I'll sort it out, but I need to sort of mull it over in my head a wee bit as to whether I should just sort of bite the bullet and go for it, you know, or if I should, if you like, find a safe harbour, if you like, you know, and just basically get in there and wait out the weather and just go tomorrow and just hope that I can get in, you know, because it's, for all intents and purposes, it is going to be just really, really horrible, and yuck, today, it's not going to be good. And like I say, the footage is not looking good at all at the moment, you know. I'm getting wee bits where I've got clear footage, but as a general rule, the raindrops keep hitting that, and it's just like, it's going to be, it's turning into a really, really rubbish day, by the way, you know. But having said that, I mean, if the weather dumps the worst of it today, you know, and then it's okay for the rest of the week, I'll take that, you know. But it's not looking good, you know. So that's the update so far, basically. I've managed to get onto the weather app. It's not going to get better, it's only going to get worse. So far the thunder's not started, but apparently thunder is on the way. It's kind of deciding whether or not I should just write the day off as a bust and moor up early somewhere nearby, or just bite the bullet and basically just go for it, you know. If I had somebody on board, you know, to help me, you know, with the ropes, you know, especially at Great Yarmouth, wouldn't be a problem. I'd just say, oh, well, just bite the bullet, you know, because I've got company there, you know, chat and whatever, and I can get kept up, topped up on the cups of coffee, you know. But at the moment, yeah, it's not looking to be very pleasant at all. But we shall wait and see. We'll wait and see how things go. Anyway, that's the update. I'll mull it over, I'll try and figure something out, and we'll see where the day takes us. So I'll keep you updated though. So until later, I'll speak to you soon. So until then, bye for now. Cheers. Okay, just a little wee update for you. oh dear. Right, I got a little bit worried there for a second. I'm approaching Cantley at the moment. Okay, I'm just now in the 5 mile an hour zone, and I'm passing the Reed Cutter pub, which is right next to the Cantley Sugar Factory. I was coming down the river, yeah, there, and the weather took quite a drastic turn for the worst. The rain started really coming down. The wind really picked up. The waves, the river, I mean, there's a wee bit of sort of waves going on due to the current going one way and the wind coming the other way, but it got really, really bad. I have prepared the canopy for just sort of putting down, you know, when I left, because I thought, well, you know, it might clear up a wee bit, you know, it might be nice, you know. I didn't, at the time when I left Sirlingham, I didn't have a signal, I didn't realise how bad the weather was going to be. So the canopy is up and it's secured, but it's ready to drop, you know. So I've taken pins out and everything like that. Now I don't know if, because I've done that, the canopy has moved slightly. I don't know if the wind is just driving the rain exponentially, but we've got some water ingress going on here, you know. It's not a lot, you know. It's just basically around the very front of the canopy and at the very back, where the flap is actually not flush and tight against it. It's been, because I took the pins out, it's like loose. So there's a wee bit of water coming in the back there, and there's a wee bit of water coming in the front. Like I say, I don't think it's nothing serious. It's not like pouring and, you know, but we've definitely got a few drips of water just coming in, and I think it's more to do with just how the rain, the wind is just driving the rain in. And I got a wee bit worried, and I thought, oh my god, you know, I mean, I was actually thinking, you know, that Breydon Water might actually be closed, because it seemed to get really, really bad. And I thought, well, if this is what it's like on the year, I mean, it's going to be like 10 times worse than Breydon, and maybe I shouldn't, you know, maybe it will be closed. And if it is going to be closed, then there's no point even going up the year, you know. I'll just find a safe little harbour down here somewhere and just deal with the situation tomorrow instead. But yeah, it's not fun. It's not fun at all. It wasn't fun at the time. However, it seems to have calmed down a wee bit. The wind's still quite strong, but it's more gusting. It's more like a strong breeze. You know, it's not like gale force winds or anything like that. I expect Breydon will be a bit choppy and a bit windy, but I think it's going to be okay. I think the crossing is going to be fine. You know, it's not going to be an issue. But it's not going to be it might be a fun crossing, but it's going to be one of these doing, doing, doing things. And I'm not entirely sure if I should pull the GoPro in or not before I make the crossing. It's fell down once or twice already, and that was in the dry, you know. And it's currently sitting out there in the wet.
excavate. Don't know what to do, you know, because if it falls off in Breydon Water, you know, I'm just not going to be able to retrieve it at all. And if the boat's moving around that much, you know, she could very well go in the drink, you know. So yeah, I'm not sure about the camera, you know. I might just actually just pull it in and say, oh, you know, you got no footage. That's the end of story. Which is a bit of a shame, because it would be pretty cool, you know. But we'll wait and see. I'll keep an eye on the weather, but I am definitely starting to think it's definitely not the best of weathers at all. Like I say, it's not stormy, but it's definitely not a good day, you know. According to the weather app, we've got it's about 15-16 miles an hour, you know, wind. So it's a strong breeze, but I don't know. Really, I'm gonna need to decide something anyway shortly, because like I say, I've just passed Cantley, so the next stop will basically be the next waypoint will be the River Shed. So if I'm going to go down to Loddon, I need to decide what I'm going to do very, very soon. Oh, the choices I sometimes have to make. Oh well, we'll wait and see, we'll wait and see. I'll keep an eye on things and maybe figure something out, you know. But that's the update so far. You're just not going to get much footage at all, I'm afraid. It's definitely a very, very rubbish sort of day today, you know. And I had thought, you know, I'll go to Great Yarmouth, you know, and I'll just sort of, you know, it'll not be that bad, you know, but I'll take a wee sort of 20-minute walk down to the seafront and spend some money in the amusements and have a wee bit of fun, you know. Maybe catch a wee takeaway on the way back to the boat and Bob's your uncle. But if it's going to be seriously miserably horrible and nasty and yuck and wet, then that might not be a very good idea. So, well, we will have to wait and see. We'll need to figure something out. Which we will. We'll figure something out. Anyway, I'm rambling. That's the update so far. I got a bit worried. I'm not so worried now because it's calmed down a little bit, but we've still got some strong wind. And the rain's eased off a wee bit as well, but yeah, we'll wait and see. We'll wait and see how things go. Okay. Anyway, until later, I'll speak to you soon. So until then, bye for now. Cheers. Okay, just a little wee update for you. The heating is on. It's got a little bit chilly there, just with the in the boat. The weather's definitely taken a turn for the worst. I've just passed the Reedham Chain Ferry, which means that I have passed the opening for the River Shed, so I am not going down to Loddon, even though I think I really ought to have gone down to Loddon. I'm going to keep on going. I have sent a message to, well, I've actually been on Facebook, and when I've got a signal, and I've been on the Broad Authority Facebook page, and so far there's no indications whatsoever about Breydon Water Crossing being closed to hire craft. They say it's still open, so in theory it should be okay. Now obviously I'm just passing, I'm going to be approaching Reedham itself shortly, within the next half hour, so it's still about 90 minutes or so up to, is it going to be 90 minutes? About 45, yeah, about 90 minutes to Great Yarmouth. It's a tough choice. It is a tough choice, you know. You want to be, you want to try and get to your destination, obviously, you know. But you want to be safe, you know. But you don't want to be too safe, you know, and just sort of be overtly panic. And I think I might be overtly panicking.
you know. But obviously, I'm just by myself, you know. So if any issues occur, you know, I've got to be very careful, you know. So I'm trying to be safe, but I don't want to be sort of too safe, you know. I mean, you've got to have trust in yourself, your abilities, the boat. I've just never done a very, very rough crossing. I think this is the worst weather crossing I've ever actually tried on Breydon Water, you know. And I know Breydon Water sometimes can be a wee bit sort of, you know, I won't say treacherous, you know, but it can catch you out sometimes. That particular crossing, it's, you know, when the weather's bad. So, you know, and I mean, any other time, you know, if I was staying another day in the Southern Broads, this weather wouldn't bother me. If I was in the Northern Broads, this weather wouldn't bother me. I would just get on with it, you know, because it's not too bad. Okay, it's wet and it's windy, you know, and the rivers are a wee bit choppy, but it's not that bad, you know. But obviously, I know what Breydon can be like sometimes, you know, and it's very open and very exposed, you know, and you can get massive amount of wind and it can get some really serious waves going on in there. And it does, in extreme weather, it will close to boats because it's just too dangerous to make a crossing. But I don't know, I mean, it's like I say, you've got to have faith in your boat. This boat seems to have quite a good wee engine in it, and I've not had cause to worry about the boat, so maybe the boat will be fine, you know. Maybe you just sometimes have to take that leap of faith, you know, trust in yourself, you know, trust in the information you have, you know, and your abilities, and just go for it, you know. Trust that you will be okay, you know. Like I said, you know, I've tried to be safe, I've tried to be sensible, you know. I've been onto the Broad Authority page. There's no mention whatsoever about Breydon being closed. On the various Facebook groups, there's no information at all about Breydon Water being closed. So yeah, I mean, it's probably going to be windy, it's probably going to be choppy. I've given up on trying to do river footage. The GoPro is still out there, still not decided if I'm taking that off before I hit Breydon or not. So yeah, like I say, I'm just, hold on a second, just need to knock a few revs off here. So yeah, what was I saying? Oh yeah, Breydon Water. Yeah, you just have to sort of trust that everything will be okay. And as long as the experts, who have plenty of experience and know these waters like the back of their hand, are okay for boats to make the crossing, then you should have trust that you will be okay, you know. So yeah, I'm obviously I've passed the River Shet there. I am currently now in Reedham. That's me just entered Reedham. So I'm going to go for it. I'm a wee bit worried because obviously I'm just by myself, you know. And at times that wind has got pretty strong. I'm feeling confident that as long as Breydon Water remains open, everything will be fine, you know. I'll make the crossing, I'll just be careful, and just pay attention to exactly how the boat is reacting on the water and how it's being affected by the wind. Make sure that if I am being blown across in a strong wind, to steer into it and try and hold a straight course without being blown too much. But like I say, if the experts are saying it's okay, then it'll be a rough crossing, I suspect, you know. And I'm quite sure that halfway across it, I'll be like, oh, that was a load of fun, you know. I'm having a ball here, you know. you know, and just end up just having a brilliant, fun-filled, you know, wave-crashing, brilliant time. But at the moment, you know, because obviously this is the worst weather crossing I have ever tried or done, I am a wee bit sort of apprehensive. You know, first time nerves, if you like, you know. But like I said, trying to be safe, trying to be sensible. I have done the some checks, you know. I have, and all checks seem to come back okay. The crossing's all right, everything's fine, and actually, I forgot to check that bridge marker. Damn. Oh no, I'll be fine, I'll be fine. The tide's actually going out. I'll be fine. Sorry, I'm just going up to Reading Swift Bridge. I totally forgot to check the bridge marker. But, oh no, it's cool. There's a bridge marker coming up just directly anyway, so I shall check that. So, anyway, I'm going to go get under this bridge and I'll keep you updated on the crossing. Okay, and we'll see how things go. So until later, I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now. Cheers! Okay, just a little wee update for you. Right, I have left Reedham and I am going up that last wee section of the River Yare, where I'm basically in the middle of no man's land right now. And the weather is continuing to be very dull, grey, black. The rain's still falling, the wind's still gusting at points, but so far though, we're doing okay. I have got a forward steer cruiser in front of me, and I was surprised. I just happened to look, but I was trying to get myself a Scotch egg for lunch, which is not easy when you're by yourself, you know, you have to be careful. No, but the fridge is literally just behind me, so I was trying to get a Scotch egg that I got with a hamper. I thought, oh, I'll have that, you know, before I hit the crossing, you know, a wee bite to eat for lunch. And I was sitting here messing around just trying to open it up, and looked behind me, and he was suddenly up my rear end, and I was just like, oh, sorry, you know, and I'm like in the middle of the river, so I'm like, oh dear. So sorry about that, room captain, although you seem to be tanking a wee bit up the river, you might not want to be moving quite so fast towards Breydon. That's the only problem, you know. I'm doing a, you're gonna arrive too early, I'm gonna arrive too early, you know. It's only, yeah, but oh well, never mind. Ideally you kind of want to be another 2 hours or so before you hit the bridges. Ideally, I have left early. I knew I was leaving early, and I knew I was going to hit the bridges at low water, not slack water, but I kind of figured, you know, as long as the outflowing current isn't too bad, I will get, because I was planning on stopping at Great Yarmouth anyway. I'm not actually sure if I'm going to stick with that plan now. I may continue up a wee bit into the Northern Broads, you know, maybe around the Stokes Bay Acot area, because I mean, if I stop at Great Yarmouth, you know, it's really going to be a horrible day, you know, and you're not really going to want to be going to do much of anything, actually, you know, whenever you moor up, you know. So yeah, I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do. I think it really all depends on the crossing, the weather, and more importantly, what it's going to be like for spaces at the yacht station, and if anybody's around there to help me, because like I say, I'm by myself, I'm going to be going against the current. I suspect the wind will be pushing me the wrong direction as well, so I need to moor on the starboard side. But with the rain and the wind and all that, I've got the canopy up and I've got no way to get out onto the starboard side. So yeah, unless, I mean, the ranges are pretty good, but I mean, that might even be a tall ask for them, especially on the low tide, and you know, I might be too low for them to grab the ropes. So I don't know. It's going to be awkward and difficult, and to tell you the truth, I'm not entirely sure. However, I suppose in some respects, I have to figure out if I can do it, if it can be done solo on the wrong side. Because I'll need to know for future. And I suppose if I try it at the worst it can possibly be and succeed, then I'm going to have the confidence of doing it any other time, you know? So, yeah. But to tell you the truth, I'm not feeling very confident about actually getting into Great Yarmouth today. If I do moor up there, it's going to be a horrible day to go anywhere, you know? And all I'm going to really want to do is sit on the boat watching Star Trek, basically. That is what I'm going to be wanting to do when I get to wherever it is I'm going to go. So I might be better just trying to get up to the Stokesby or Acle, and that way I can at least go to the pub, you know, or a beer. The only problem with that idea is I'm quite sure that a lot of other people are not really wanting to go anywhere either today. So they might even be a bit sort of, those places might be full. So I don't know. It's going to be a difficult decision, but it's something that I will find out very, very shortly, you know. Like I say, I'm sorry that I've stopped recording any footage, because it's just going to be a bit miserable and hopeless, and there's just going to be nothing but raindrops on the camera. You may have already seen a wee bit of rain footage already, and it's just it's a lot worse now than it was earlier, you know. So we've got some issues up here as well. The wind is picking up, the waves are starting to get all choppy. So yeah, I'm gonna go there now because we've got that bathtub seems to be struggling a wee bit. So I'll go there now and I'll keep you updated and I'll speak to you soon. Okay, hopefully next time you speak to me I'll be on Breydon Water. Right, so until later, bye for now. Cheers! Bloody disappointment. Oh my goodness me, you know? All that palaver and worry and, you know, oh, is it going to be okay, you know, and what state is it going to be in, you know? It's fine. absolutely fine. It's a bit breezy, right enough, you know, but there's no wild, you know, those like white horses, you know. The water's a wee bit sort of ripply, but there's no waves. The boat's no rocking or anything like that. And there's just no issues whatsoever. It was bloody worse. It was rougher on the River Yare. Just up by, just before I hit Cantley. This is nothing. No, all that bloody worry. I was getting myself so worked up for nothing. I mean, I'm glad it's a good crossing, you know, and I'm glad there's no issues, but, you know, after considering how busy it was on the River Yare, you know, and the weather we've been having, I was expecting to see at least a few waves, you know. I wanted to get some little sort of wave action and bow you know, all that, you know, but splashing. Well, it's just nothing. So we're just cutting through it, no problems, you know. Like I say, there's a bit of a strong crosswind, as expected, because it was quite breezy, you know, and it's still quite wet, so I mean, I've still not got any sort of camera footage at the moment, you know, because it's just, you just see nothing but rain on the camera. But yeah, I mean, it's fine. It's fine, there's no problems at all. And I'm just like, oh my god, well, that was sort of, I mean, like I say, you know, I'm glad the crossing's fine, but considering what it was like on the River Yare and how choppy that got, you know, and I was expecting to see, you know, I was expecting to see, like, whoa, you know, I'm not saying, like, I expected a rough crossing, you know, I expected lots of waves and lots of splashing and lots of panic and then excitement, you know. It's just no happening. It's a very uneventful crossing indeed. Ah, well, so much for that then. This goes to show you never really do know, do you? You know, I mean, after coming down the River Yen there, before I hit Cantley, you know, I mean, the river did get very, very choppy. The wind was like really strong against me. The boat was rocking, you know. The waves were, there was actual proper waves on the river, and it was crashing against the hull, you know. And the rain got very torrential as well, you know. And after that, I thought, well, if this is what it's like in the year, what's it going to be like on blinking Breydon, you know? And I did get a bit worried about it all, you know, and that's what prompted me to start thinking, oh, well, maybe I should be making inquiries, you know, just to see how bad Breydon is. But it's fine, no problems whatsoever, you know. So, yeah, I mean, it was good that, I mean, I checked out the God's Authority page, you know. I was trying to be sensible and safe, you know, and there was nothing about it causing there. I thought, well, okay, it's going to be rough, but it's not going to be that bad. Well, as it is, it's not even rough, you know. Just, yeah, so there you go. All that worry for nothing, honestly. Sometimes you just feel like an idiot, you know. This is why I call myself an idiot on the boat. No idea what he's doing, totally wings it, you know. But, oh well, never mind. So, as it is, it turns out it was a good idea to actually make the crossing today after all, because the day is very miserable and horrible and yuck, so I may as well have made it. It was a good decision to actually come across here after all. The only problem is I'm still not sure about whether I'm going to get in at Great Yarmouth or not. So we shall have to wait and see what happens with that. I'll maybe, like I say, I've not been taking any river footage because the rain's just been torrential. But I'll maybe try and put the camera on and see if I can capture anything going under the bridges and mooring up, and we'll see what happens with that situation there. And if not, then so be it. I'll switch it off, and next I'll probably speak to you, it'll be in Sorksby or something, you know, but we'll wait and see. Anyway, I'm gonna go continue crossing Breydon here. Everything's going fine. The crossing is not that bad, but there's a bit of ripply and there's a little wee bit of a crosswind, but other than that, it's fine, you know. So no dramatic footage, you know, of bows ploughing into waves and all that. Unfortunately, I'll have to leave that for another time. So yeah, all is going well, there's no problems, and we're just making the crossing uneventfully without incident. So yeah, I will keep you updated, and until later, I'll speak to you soon. So until then, bye for now. Cheers!
Okay, just a little wee update for you.
I am at Great Yarmouth.
Oh yeah. I made it basically. I came across Breydon Water. It wasn't actually as rough as I thought it was gonna be. I'm both very grateful for that, but also more than a little disappointed about that, actually, if I'm honest, you know. I got myself so worked up and worried after what the River Yare was like that I was expecting full on, you know, proper sort of waves and, oh, you know, I was expecting a challenging crossing. And in the end, it just wasn't. It was a normal crossing, just with a little bit of wind and rain. But yeah, I came under the bridges, obviously plenty of room, not a problem. I did have the issue, obviously, how was I going to get in here? As I came up the river, I saw there was a space just pretty much outside the yacht station, and all I did is, when I was ready to moor up, I lowered the canopy, got myself ready, but by the time I was pulled in by the side of the quay heading, the two rangers were there. They took my ropes, got me all organised and sorted, you know, so they actually helped me moor up and secure the boat, and everything was great. I have paid for an overnight mooring, so that's £13, and for the sake of £1, you know, I even grabbed the shower token for tomorrow. I'll probably just get a shower on the boat tonight. But tomorrow morning I can get up, you know, 8 o'clock, you know, and off-ski. Obviously, I haven't actually topped up my water yet on this trip, because I haven't really been using water so far. Just the way things are working out, I've been using a lot of sort of external showers. So yeah, I've not used that much water on board the boat, so I know that my water tank's fine, but I will top up my water probably tomorrow. Actually, I'll top it up and get myself organized quite early and get off up the river, no problems. I'm not entirely sure what time I'm going to be leaving or exactly where I'm going to be going. I know where I'm ending up tomorrow, which is the Lion, once again. Excellent. I know I've already been to the Lion, I know, but you know, if Moonlight Shadow is going to be there, you know, and I think there's somebody else that might be, David and Dawn Curtis, I think they might be turning up at the at Thorndyke as well, so they might be coming along. So, you know, go along to Thorndyke, you know, have a wee little sort of Admirals meetup, have a look at Moonlight Shadow, a very nice boat, I believe, and yeah, basically, why not? Go for it, you know? And you can't go wrong with spending two nights in 1 week at the Lion, as far as I'm concerned, especially if they've got that whiskey cask cider on. Lovely. I'm expecting a bit of a hangover tomorrow, so it might be another prudent to get another early night tonight. But yeah, I am here. Obviously, the Rangers helped me in. And I could have kept on going, but, you know, although Breydon Water was not as bad as I expected it to be, it's still pretty bloody wild out there. I mean, it's rubbish, you know, it's wet, it's windy, you know, it's just horrible. And to tell you the truth, it's like, do I even want to go into Great Yarmouth, you know? I mean, why did I stop here? For what reason, you know? Just for the bloody amusements down. I mean, are you going to be so stubborn about that? They're probably shut. That's the worst of it. I'll probably go down there and they're all shut, you know? What can I say? It's just sometimes I'm a big kid, you know? You know? But no, I just quite fancied, you know, I think the thing is that I could do with the walk, you know, more than anything else, because I've not really been doing much walking, you know, I've not really been going, doing much activity at all on this trip. So, I think it'll be actually good to actually get off the boat, have a walk, you know. I did know there was going to be rain, so I've got a good, hopefully, warm jacket with me. I ain't going to put a brolly up. I've got a brolly,
ain't putting a brolly up in this wind, because that'll just end up inside out. So, but I've got a wee hat, you know, so warm jacket, nice wee hat, you know. Bite the bullet, go for a wee walk, you know, it doesn't matter what I do or where I go, just go for a walk, you know, get off the boat. I need to decide what I'm doing for dinner though, that's the only thing, because obviously there's no pub, not a problem, I've got plenty of beer and wine on board. I need to figure out exactly what I am going to do for food tonight. There is a, I believe it's a Morrison's, or is it an Asda? Oh no, that's a quick, I think it's a Morrison's, just down the road on the way to the seafront, so I can get something for dinner there, bring it back here, cook on board. No! Cooking on board! Ah! You know? Or, obviously there's plenty of places to eat out there, you know, or maybe, I don't know, I mean I believe there's a Chinese that delivers here, you know? That's quite reasonable. Not sure, you know, but I don't know. Maybe just have a Chinese bottle of wine, a lot of Star Trek, Deep Space Nine. Could be. I've even got some. I even brought my obligatory Star Wars films. I told you I'm a major science fiction geek. Okay, I'm sorry. You know, it's just one of the things you have to deal with, especially if you joined my Facebook page, you know. And I know a lot of people have sort of been sending me friend requests, you know, and I'm quite careful about who exactly I add to my Facebook page now, because I have been getting weird messages sometimes, and some of the requests are like, that's dodgy, you know. So usually a message and a wee request, you know, that's usually, I just add them, you know, if I like what they say. I think there's been a few people that have joined my Facebook page thinking, oh, it's Russell, you know, he's out there on the boats, you know, and you get the Facebook page and then all of a sudden they get bombarded by copious amounts of cats and science fiction posts. And some really weird psychological, philosophical thoughts as well, that just like, what the hell? The guy's a nutter! Leave him! I'm running away! He's just leave! Just go! So yeah, so if you have joined my personal Facebook page and you're still a member of it, then yeah, they're grunting for punishment sometimes, I think. Anyway, what was I saying? I've no idea. I'm babbling. I'm talking rubbish. Oh, yes. I am obviously here at Great Yarmouth. I've no idea what I'm doing for dinner, so yeah. I don't know if this is the end of day 4 of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 10. I'm here for the night, that's it. I'm not going anywhere else. Whether gets better or worse, I don't know, but this is it. This is where I'm staying. So it's just a matter of figuring out what's going to happen next. The weather's too wild, so I probably won't be taking the camera out with me, because there's just no way I would say anything. I might pop back later though, just to say, I don't know, just maybe sort of update you a wee bit on the various, is that Crystal Emblem giving me a wave? I'm not sure if Crystal Emblem gave me a wave there, or anything. I don't know, but just in case, Crystal Emblem, if you pass me a Great Yarmouth, hello. I just caught you, just you were passing by, it's just hello. But, what was I saying? Oh, totally thrown me, you know? I might pop back later, you know, just to give you a wee update on exactly what I have done since I moved up here, you know? But in case I don't pop back, I'll say this is the end of day 4 of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 10. I know it's been a talky one and there's not really been much footage, to tell you the truth, you know, the footage would have been rubbish, honestly. You know, you would have got, there's just really not much to see, and there's a lot of rain, and yeah, it would just been, yeah. So, there's some footage, so you might get some footage, and I apologise for any raindrops on the camera, if I have posted any of the river footage. But, yeah. I hope you are, but yeah, I will possibly nip back later, but just in case I don't, this is the end of day 4, the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 10, and I will possibly, I know where I'm needing to go for tomorrow, I just don't know what I'm going to do tomorrow, unless I pop back later, thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it, despite the weather, and despite my panicking. I will see you, if I don't see you later, I will see you tomorrow at day 5, you know, back into the Northern Broads we go. So, yeah, I think I'm going to enjoy it today, actually, you know, but we'll see what happens, okay. I'll probably go out there and catch hypothermia or something like that, and that'll be that's one of a mistake. Anyway, enough of that. Thanks for watching. I'll see you tomorrow at day 5 if I don't pop back later. So until then, I'll speak to you later. Bye for now. Cheers. Okay, just a little wee update for you. I'm back. I'm back just now, at least. And I am still at Great Yarmouth, and would you believe the change in only a few hours, you know? Okay, it's still breezy out there, but the rain has stopped, the sun is trying to come out, and oh my goodness, it is humid, very humid, you know? It's like, just a complete opposite of what it was a couple of hours later, earlier, you know, this morning, because that was it was a bit strange actually how the river Yare was actually worse than Breydon Water. I thought Breydon Water, if the river Yare was going to be bad, I thought Breydon Water would be horrendous. But as it turned out, maybe it was just a freak, maybe it was just the way things worked, I don't know. But Breydon Water wasn't as bad as I was expecting, but I was a wee bit disappointed at that, because I was kind of hoping that it was actually, I mean, despite the fact that I was panicking a wee bit about it, I was kind of actually hoping for like the big waves and all that, you know, have a little bit of fun, but oh well, never mind. I'm just back. I have spent a lovely afternoon, actually, out and about in Great Yarmouth. I didn't do anything or anything like that, I just basically had a walk. I walked all the way down to the seafront, along the seafront, nipping into all the various amusements and arcades and all the wee sort of shops and everything like that. Have a wee look, see what was there. Quite surprised, actually, because, I mean, I know it's the end of September, but you know, I would have thought there's still a few people out and about, but a lot of it's actually shut down. Seems to be shut down for the season, and I was like, wow, okay. You know, because it was only like 2-3 months or something like that that I was down in July. And, I mean, it was bouncing, you know, absolutely bouncing, you know. But, a couple of months later, and it's all quiet and everything's pretty much shut up shop, but there were still a few things going on, you know. So, but it was more just for the walk, you know, and I enjoyed the walk, actually, surprisingly, you know. That'll be the Aykroyd family rubbing off on me a little, Yeah, Susan, I got my steps in today, yes, oh yes I did. Don't know how many I've done, but, you know, judging by the way my feet are aching, I think I've done a fair few, you know. But yeah, I mean, I just walked along the seafront, back up and into the actual town itself, had a wee look in the shops, and then back to the boat, you know, and back to the boat, and I have the obligatory wine on the go with stemmed wine glasses. Lovely. And I nipped into the yacht station's office and I picked up a menu for a Chinese. So I think it might be a Chinese and wine night tonight on the boat, watching mind-numbing, incredibly bad science fiction TV. Well, actually, it's incredibly bad for you. It's bloody excellent for me. So yeah, that is pretty much my evening planned. And I've got to say, it was actually a good day, you know. I'm quite glad I left when I did, you know. And I'm quite glad I decided to actually stop at Great Yarmouth. It just broke up the journey a wee bit more, and I was in no rush to get back up north, you know. I could have gone up and could have got stuck in Stokes Bay. Well, not stuck, but I could have stopped at Stokes Bay. But then, you know, I would have had, well, you know, considering I have to go to the Thorndike tomorrow, there's a possibility it's turning into an Admiral's meetup, by the way. What was I saying? Yeah, so I have to end up at Thorndike, and if I was at Stokes Bay, you know, it's not that long a cruise to Thorndike, so at least from here up there, you know, you're looking at a good couple of hours, maybe two, three hours maybe, to get up there. And I could maybe even leave early enough and go to Potterheim, you know, have a wee look around Latham's, you know, maybe get a wee sort of cake for everybody. Cake and beer. Does that work? I don't know. I don't know, but if it's from Latham's, I might just try it anyway. But yeah, so like I say, I don't know what I'm doing. But I picked up a token for the showers. I thought, why not? You know, I mean, it's like I say, there's nothing wrong with the boat showers, you know. But you just get a wee bit more room in the showers, you know. I just figured, oh well, what the hell, it's only a pounder, you know. So I picked up a token. I'll get in there tomorrow morning, I think they open at 8 o'clock, you know. So I'll go in there, have a shower, get myself organised, top up my water before I leave, because I'm needing to do that. And then I can just head on up the road, up the river, you know, maybe about 9, half 9 or something like that. Get up there for about lunchtime. Bob your uncle, you know, sorted. Excellente. So yeah, that is essentially me. Everything's going good. The boat's performing well. Shelob is still in her wee corner, I noticed. So that's still off limits down there. I'm not going down there, forget it, you know. Have you seen the size of her? She's massive, by the way, you know. She's got eyes on me, you know. She's liking the size of me, a good juicy meal, you know. Although, judging by the size of her, I'm nothing more than a mere snack, by the way. So I was keeping away from her. She can live there in peace, you know. Don't bother me, I won't bother her. Anyway, I'm going to say that's the end of day 4, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, day 4. I'm going to say this is the end of day 4 now. I might be back later, I don't know. We'll wait and see. We'll see what happens later on tonight, you know. I don't really, like I say, I'm not really going anywhere. I'm not really doing anything. I'm just taking things easy for the night. I'm just going to relax and chill. Unwind, basically, you know. I've had a... It was busy weekend meeting everybody, actually, just saying that, I should actually mention Jeff. I should send my apologies to Jeff, publicly apologise to Jeff, the poor guy. Can you believe it? Obviously, I posted that I was at Sirlingham Ferry House last night. So I went away, had a few beers, you know, had my dinner, went back to the boat. Another beer or two, watched a wee bit of Star Trek, but then after over the weekend, you know, I totally crashed. I was wiped out, and I was in my bed by about 7:30, something like that. And poor guy, you know, I felt so bloody guilty, you know, because he actually drove down to Sirlingham Ferry House, you know, to meet me, you know. And I was just like, oh man, you know, I didn't get the message, the missed calls until I got a signal. Apparently he was speaking to somebody that had moored up, you know.
And he said, well, if you see him tomorrow, just tell him that I was here. And I was just like, oh, man. You know, that's the second time, I think, Jeff has tried to get in touch with me. Because I think it was in June when I met up with Anne and Alan on Moonbeam at Echo Bridge Inn. I think he turned up then. But I was there. You know, we just literally missed each other. And then last night, he turned up at Sarlingham Ferry House, and it was just, oh man, you know, so, I actually feel guilty about that. So, yeah, I apologise, Jeff, I'm sorry. I would have been up any other night, but, you know, like I say, I was wiped out, I was knackered, I just passed out completely. I have sent my apologies to him, and, hopefully, next time, we'll try and organise something in advance, you know, and we'll say, right, okay, I will definitely be there, and I will definitely wait on you, okay? So, yeah, definitely, but that's just a bit of a shame. Anyway, so I apologise, Jeff. I'm sorry I missed you again last night. It was just a circumstance again, you know, but such things happen, I suppose. Right, so this is the end of day 4. If you have been watching, thank you very much. I might be back later, I doubt it. I think I'm just going to chill and have a relaxing evening tonight. But if I am back later, I'll speak to you later. And if not, I shall see you tomorrow on day 5 of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure, where we go back up the river into the Northern Broads proper. Not sure where we're going, what we're going to do, but we will end up at Thurndyke, where we are going to meet up with a couple of people there, you know. So, looking forward to that. That's going to be a good night, you know. That really is going to be a good night, by the way. I'm expecting not to remember too much about that night again. especially if that whiskey cask cider is on. Oh, God. It's really good, by the way. It's really good. But, oh, couple of two or three pints of that. Ah, no problems. You're feeling happy, you're feeling good. You walk outside in the fresh air, it's like, oh, hello, baby. Hello. So, yeah, it's bloody good stuff, though. Anyway, I'm gonna go off on a tangent. So, right. Thanks for watching. I'll see you tomorrow if I'm not back later. Until later, I'll speak to you soon. So until then, bye for now. Good night. Cheers.